no. Now scream my name out. Do you want it fast or shall I hit it slow? Not to mention the multiple positions I inflict. A boss play a freaky motherfucker can a dick.
It's only popping. Now you see what I was seeing. Why your eyes rolling? Loosen up, girl. I ain't going nowhere. Let's let that sucker stay out there. While he stress out and knock, I stress out the cop. Hold the boots and let the nigga execute. And though you got it right, I'm going home tonight.
You say you don't need a man, but I don't care. You in the presence of a player.
I want to be your man. I'm IGGA. So you can get drunk and smoke weed all day. It don't matter if you're lonely, baby. You need a thug in your life. These monsters ain't love in your right. I'd rather be your man.
Ran across, you ever run across some weird shit on Facebook? Like just scrolling through and you see some weird ass articles and shit. I just ran across one. The main headline of this shit is, your vagina is more beautiful than you think. You know what? It really depends. It depends because vagina in general is fucking awesome. I've seen some bad ones. Ugh. Look like you kicked a raw chicken across the street. For real, though. Look like fucking roast beef slammed against the wall. But I'm about to read this article because I have to see what the fuck it is. What are they even talking about? Oh, here, we got the brief portion of it. It says, in brief, filmmaker Layla Martin was inspired to capture the gap. Wait, did they really just call it the gap? Oh, no, the gap that can sometimes exist between how a woman sees her body and the way her lover views it. So she made a documentary called The Perfect Vagina, documenting different kinds of vaginas, and so this broad just basically went around, made a whole movie about vaginas, just had different chicks show their snatch on camera and called it a documentary. That's the double standard right there. That's the fucking double standard right fucking there. If I went around with a camera asking chicks to show their vagina, they might do it. They might, I mean, I get a few girls flashing their cunts probably, but it's just the fact that I would look creepy doing it. I would just be a creepy guy with a camera trying to see girls' cunts. That's what it comes down to. A woman can go around with a camera. Hell, she can even make it artistic and be like, hey, can I see your balls? And the first dude gets a hard-on, fucking gets a sexual harassment charge. That, I'm telling you, it's a fucked up world we living in. Hopefully it gets better this year, 2019. And if you do want to see the documentary, I might have to do a little research on it later, alone. It's called The Perfect Vagina. I'll have to look up on the internet where that's at. You know, just do a Google search on vagina and see what comes up, and you'll probably find a video pertaining to it. Might not be the same documentary, but it'll be a documentary, nonetheless. But with that being said, we're going to get into, figure that was some good shit for Battle of the Sexes, a little vagina news. But we're going to go ahead and get into some Coolio, Gangster's Paradise. Keeps the old school fucking flow going real quick. Check it out.
Tell me what this is all about. As I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I take a look at my life and realize there's nothing left. Cause I've been blasting and laughing so long that even my mama thinks that my mind is gone. But I ain't never crossed a man that didn't deserve it. Me be treated like a punk, you know that's unheard of. You better watch how you're talking and where you're walking, or you and your homies might be lying in chalk. I really hate the trip, but I gotta lope. As they croak, I see myself in the pistol smoke. Fool, I'm the kind of G the little homies wanna be like. On my knees in the night, saying prayers in the streetlight.
Been spending most of the night living in the gangster's paradise. Been spending most of the night living in the gangster's paradise. Keep spending most of the night living in the gangster's paradise. Keep spending most of the night living in the gangster's paradise.
Look at the situation they got me facing. I can't live a normal life. I was raised by the state, so I gotta be down with the hood team. Too much television watching got me chasing dreams. I'm an educated fool with money on my mind. Got my tin in my hand and a gleam in my eye. I'm a loped out gangster, set tripping banker. And my homies is down, so don't arouse my anger. Fool, death ain't nothing but a heartbeat away. I'm living life, do or die. What can I say? I'm 23 now, but will I live to see 24? The way things is going, I don't know.
Tell me why.
After minute, hour after hour, everybody's running, but half of them ain't looking what's going on in the kitchen. But I don't know what's cooking. They say I got to learn, but nobody's here to teach me. If they can't understand it, how can they reach me? I guess they can't, I guess they won't, I guess they front. That's why I know my life is out of luck, fool.
Say rest in peace to me and Gene Okerlund, the legendary WWF interviewer. Yeah, I said WWF. I don't conform with the WWE bullshit. But yeah, rest in peace, man. I remember watching him on TV when I was a kid, back when I used to watch wrestling and shit. That's sad. He died at 76. But it's fucking, you know what? Wrestling started to suck when they changed it to WWE. There used to be different sectors. There was the WCW, you had the ECW, you had the NWO, then you had the separate entity of NWO, the NWO Wolfpack, and then you had your WWF. And then stupid WWF wildlife people had to fucking cry about it and get the wrestling shit changed. I wanted the WWF wildlife people to change their name because it pissed me off on like fucking, it'd be like a Sunday afternoon and shit when there was nothing on TV back before we had all this on demand and digital cable shit. Back when you used to have to watch the TV Guide Network and that shit would just roll hella slow past and you just have to wait for your channel to scroll past and see what was going to be on the channel you wanted to watch. And I'd see WWF and I'm in the jungle or some fucking stupid shit like that. And I'm thinking, fuck, they're doing like a special WWF thing. They're in the jungle, getting down with the lions, putting the fucking herd on them. And then I look and it's just people saving fucking whales and shit. Or whatever the fuck they save. There's not whales in the jungle, but you know what the fuck I'm talking about. Hi, give me a break. Okay. But yeah, it was just bullshit, you know, and that's when we started giving in to just stupid shit. That's when society, in general, started just giving in to shit. Just because they got tired of hearing people cry about things. It's fucking retarded. It really is. Watch, someone's going to complain that I said retarded. But, you know, we're going to go ahead and get into... We did some old school, let's do some newer shit. We got some 2 Chainz and some Future. Let's do a back-to-back. Start out with some 2 Chainz. Feds watching. Check it out.
Swimming with them barracudas. Close the docket on that motherfucking prosecutor.